A lot of your early thinking that drove the work on human development. I mean, as you said, if you put the result first, what do you want development to achieve for people, and then how do people therefore engage to get to that place? You gave significant centrality also to this whole issue of education and the kind of education. And yet we see countries where, you know, the focus is very much and supported by, you know, a number of international institutions and conventions on primary education. We see other countries that said, well, yes, that's all fine, but we've got to consistently keep investing in our secondary and tertiary education, because you're not going to move your country forward along a certain track. Now, we know that knowledge and then, you know, in a systematic way, education is so much at the heart of people's capability and then what they want to do. What do you feel about
well,
that?
Well, I feel the importance of education is, first of all, the recognition of that. Education in general is perhaps the most important thing to accept and emphasize and work for. Nothing as important as education. And yet, we have the choices to be faced given the institutional as well as budgetary limitation. Now there, I must say, when we were doing the human development thing, my view was similar to the person I was, he was a very close friend and was working for, namely Mahbub ul Haq from Pakistan, who and he and I were undergraduates together in Cambridge, and we talked about them even when we were undergraduate, the centrality of primary education. We agreed on that. So when Mahbub took charge of the human development report office and started producing the human development reports, we worked out, and we had no disagreement on that, that the first focus has to be on primary education. This doesn't mean that secondary education is unimportant or university education is unimportant. That's not the case. They are very important. But A, you can't do secondary education and university education without doing primary education first. And B, to put your money on educating a small group of primary educated people to give them more and more education while leaving lots of people out of the primary education is one of the gravest injustices that one can think of. So that's why in the context of the Human Development Index, for example, which I helped Mahbub to construct, we were clear, both Mahbub and I, that we wanted to, and there were other advisors working with us at that time. I was not the only one. And that was, we had a clear focus that primary education has to be placed as very central. So literacy became very important, though years of schooling came in, which included secondary schooling as well. So we added that, but the primary education remained very central. So my position is still the same, that we should not make secondary education the enemy of primary education. We need, I think there's no case why we should not have universal primary education in every country in the world today. It doesn't cost that much money, and it has a huge reward to pay. So to the extent that people emphasize that, I'm in favor of that very much. But to the extent that that is meant to mean, that is interpreted to mean that secondary education and university education could be neglected, that's just not right. You have to change. There are lots of things, and this in the context of Africa, this is particularly important, because quite often the higher education establishment are also very badly underdeveloped. And while primary education is not widespread, it's not the only failure that we have to address. So I think it's a question of having a balance there.